wonderful, and the people are so great here. And the orchestra is just fantastic. I know these musicians for 15 years, and we just, you know, perform so many different pieces, and work with them, and every time be here and share with you this great music. It's very special for me.
Did we have a question over here?
Yes, I was wondering if you could speak to what it is you're listening to as you're going through the preliminary and the second round, because I was listening to as much of the live stream as I could, and I went to one of the sessions, and I know what I like style of judging, and I would think that choosing four from the people I heard would be impossible. So how did we get from 24 to four?
Yeah, you know, it's very difficult to choose, you know, from 21, 11, and from 11 specifically, four, you know. Unfortunately, competition is a competition, you know. All the jury members have their particular ideas and their own personal opinion. So, actually, I was happy to see you know, more or less same option and opinion on this or another contestant. So it was difficult to choose, definitely. But I think that pretty much we are happy with the results for the final. And, you know, we were looking, of course, from the first round, I really wanted to, because as artistic director of the competition, I thought that the first round, preliminary round, should have polyphony as a Bach, of course, and then some classical sonata, and then, of course, etudes to show the technique, and a piece by Rachmaninoff, because Rachmaninoff is a very special composer for me, and not only for me, but for the old pianist, Rachmaninoff is a very important and special composer. So I really wanted to see all the 21 contestants, how they will do that, how they will do this task. So it was easy to see who was definitely better in all the composers than others. So we choose 11. And then afterwards, that was kind of a different step. The semifinal is just they are showing us, first of all, how they can put together a good program. Because a good program is very important in the recital. You know, no one except me, you know, knows what to put in a program for the recital. You know, a presenter is never asking for specific pieces. Yes, maybe one from the whole recital, but everything else is your own way. And the programming is not easy, and sometimes it just doesn't work, you know? The composers doesn't work together. So you need to be very smart and clever about the programming your recital.
And it really shows you something about the person's,
the deepness, the understanding, everything is very important. And second of all, we were looking for someone who has aura around and the charisma on stage, and not just playing notes or anything. I know that everyone has a different approach, but for me, I can feel immediately when the person is sharing music with me. So, you know, that was the pretty much it. And of course, with the final round, we are looking for someone who can work with the orchestra, who can work with the conductor, who can listen to the orchestra, who is a real artist. So I'm glad that we have a, you know, real full competition when you have not just the solo recitals, but also opportunity to work with the orchestra, because then you can see a real artist. I hope that the next competition, which will be happening every 3 years here, so in 3 years, I really hope that we can also add a chamber music round, because to see how the young musician work with the trio or quartet is also totally different. It's very intimate atmosphere, it's totally different approach. So I hope this will happen for the next competition.
And that's what your career is.